talk about some of the other sectors that often are fragmented, continue to be fragmented, underpenetrated? Insurance is one of them, and you're making a big bet there as well.
Yeah, insurance. I'm making a bet. I'm trying to make a bet in health, because I think health is a crying need. You know, today the biggest cause of rural and urban indebtedness is
out-of-pocket expenses.
And I don't think government can administer any scheme of any significance.
So you don't put too much weight behind this Ayushman Bharat program that's expected
There's
to be rolled out later.
There's already there.
Later the year.
Right, and I don't understand it, because today if I go with a heart problem to JJ Hospital, the government does operate me. So I don't know, but I think, you know, today at 10,000, 12,000 rupees, you can insure a family for 5 lakhs rupees. You know, my pune, he can even afford it, easily 1,000 rupees a month, right? And India has reached that per capita GDP level where a lot of discretionary spending on health and education. Mm. And don't forget, we are at least 20 to 30 crore Indians who are at $7,000-$8,000 of per capita, who can eminently, you know, afford health insurance. So I think it's an underpenetrated sector. It's going to grow at, in my opinion, at the rate of 20 to 30% for the next 10, 15 years. Mm. Right, and it's a good area. So.
I don't know how much you want to publicly talk about your proposed investment or not, but let me hazard a chance here with that. What is the aspiration with this big insurance bet that you're making with Star?
Aspiration is to make money. Yeah. What
yes.
else?
But are you actually going to be hands-on running it?
No, I don't be in here. My office. Is my office, I don't go anywhere. I've got a team, we will be doing it jointly. Mm. It already has a very good management team.
Mm. Are you looking at similar such opportunities where you could put in that kind of money and the aspiration is not merely an investment?
If I feel a risk is worth taking and I can afford the ability to be wrong, that even if I go wrong, my financial stability will not be affected. I'll take a bet anytime.
Is there anything on the horizon which looks similar to the kind of bet that you're willing to make on insurance?
No, there are things on the horizon, but much smaller.
Mm.
I don't have that kind of money to put in so many other companies. And I'm looking at a lot of opportunities, but they're much smaller.
When do you expect closure on the insurance deal?
Who knows? Maybe this month, for first week of July, maybe.
Huh. But are you going to be getting your hands dirty with that venture? I mean, beyond just the money and putting the team together?
No, I cannot. See, my idea of life is strategy. And my idea of life is not operations. So, and you know, you can grow big in life with the effort of others. It depends on whom you choose and what freedom they have. And what rewards they have. So I am hands up. I mean, I have no capability. Let's understand one thing. Let's not try to do, just because we have money, let's not try to do something for which we are not capable.
Hmm. Okay, so since you're betting on health insurance, what about health delivery? Because, you know, the two are linked, and this is again an underserved, underpenetrated.
Health insurance is not a capital intensive business. Hmm. Health insurance is very capital intensive until you break even. It's very difficult to break even.
Hmm.
Once you break even, it's not capital intensive, it's a cash flow business. A hospital is a constant investment business, constant investment. So the return on capital there is, you know, I bought Apollo Hospital, 5% of it in 1992.
Hmm.
And I sold it for 20 times its value in 2000, right? But I find it's too capital intensive industry.
So you wouldn't be interested in the sector?
In general,
there are
I won't
also
be interested.
Questions on the business model and how the business model currently is
worldwide
broken.
Worldwide, it is the same.
Yeah.
It's all these people who are shouting. When their relative goes to the ICU, what will they do? They'll sue the hospital or they'll treat the patient.
Hmm.
This is the same worldwide. It's not only India.
Hmm. So you can...
That regulatory, nothing's going to happen. People are going to keep shouting.
Well, you believe that it continues to be capital intensive, unlike the insurance business, which after a certain point does not require that kind of capital. But is this a sector that you would look at least some of the interesting opportunities?
Won't close my eyes to any opportunity.
Huh.
But I made my money in 92 to 2000.
So what is the Fortis bet about then?
I have a very small, I have 50, 65 lakh shares, I have a small bet.
Hmm. So that's just fun and games. Where else are you interested in fun and games, so to speak?
It's not fun and games, there's serious money. Even 65 lakh shares is 80-90 crores of rupees. But it's not a very big... And I don't want to go to areas where there's conflict.
Where there's conflict?
When they called me and they I think someone from the Economic Times spoke to me. So I told them, I only say two things, that a board appointed by shareholders who are no longer shareholders is going to decide who's going to take over the companies. That's blatantly unfair. That board has to be removed and you have to run a due process. But that's what they are doing today. That's the only comment I made at that time.
Okay. Real estate, you talked about how pharma is perhaps seen the worst, banking is perhaps seen the worst. What about the real estate space? Is that something that at this point you feel...
See, this is an industry in the process of transformation, right? The return, if you look at the balance sheet of Indian listed companies, and if you look at the capital employed, you know, the return on capital in the last 10 years on average has been 7%, 8%, 9%, right? What I personally feel is that real estate prices won't go up, but volumes will go up. And people are underestimating the effect of the affordable housing on India in general, and the subsidy the government is providing. So I think real estate has
bottomed. But that hasn't really taken off much. I mean, the...
Ma'am, in 18, 19, we are going to cumulatively build three times the houses we built in 16, 17 and 17, 18. This side will take off.
So is this a sector that you would look at?
Yeah, I mean, I have investments in the sector.
And you believe
I've already looked at it.
You've already looked at it and you believe that this is ripe for better times ahead
I
now?
I think so.
And you expect that to happen within the next year or so?
Next 2-3 years.
Where else, you know, we can talk about retail, we can talk about some of the other spaces where consumption, of course, continues to be the driver. When you, on balance, look at the growth opportunity, valuations, earnings recovery, you know, is there a matrix that today where there are some sectors that stand out?
The only rules are that there are no rules. And there's no metrics and there's no... That's not how I invest, actually. See, we look at... Rather than looking at sectors, I look at specific opportunities. And one thing I've learned that the lesser the prejudice and lesser the prejudgment I have, the better the investment. So if opportunities come, I look at them with open mind. I'm not close to any industry.
In the consumption space, what would look exciting today?
I think they're well valued now. I think people
are too bullish. The QSR bets, etc., and all of that are well valued?
Well valued, and people are too bullish. I mean, it's going to be very good, but all that is priced in, according to me. According to me, in the next 5 years, you will get a return, which is lower than earnings increase. But I feel the P's will correct.
Okay. On the specifically in a lot of the consumption stocks that have already run up quite significantly.
Could be.
Okay. So where else do you believe that, you know, we're in that space where at least in the short to medium term, you know, value...
See, I'm bullish on India in general.
Right? That you've been...
No, and in the Indian markets in particular. Now, I don't, you know, I have no formal allocation of money. Right. And if I had made all those formal allocations and reduced my portfolios because one company was too big, I wouldn't have the wealth I have today. Luckily, I didn't do all that. So the companies which perform well remained, right? So I don't look at things from the point of view of sector and look at the point of view of the companies.
You know, since you're bullish on the Indian stock markets, you're obviously also looking at the infrastructure behind the Indian stock markets. MCX is a bet as well.
Yeah, they're doing well. Volumes have gone up like anything.
So you know, affiliated to the Indian stock market story, bets like MCX, is there any other interesting, exciting opportunity?
Yeah, I have made some interesting opportunities. You'll hear about them.
When will we hear about them?
Whenever the transactions are completed.
So I was hoping you'd give us...
I made some agreements to buy some market infrastructure company.
Okay.
Small portion of it. So whenever it is, I'm under an NDA. Whenever it's disclosed, it will be disclosed.
Do you expect that to happen within the next few weeks, next few months?
Next few months.
And this is a single investment or there are multiple investments?
No, single investment.
Single investment.
Where's the money for multiple investments?
Okay. So what would concern you today? Because, you know, we've gone through a phase of fairly benign macros. The micros are now starting to pick up. From a global perspective, you know, what are the events that you're watching out for? What are the triggers that you're
watching out for? What can really upset India's fiscal and monetary situation and the foreign exchange is oil prices. I think the oil price remained between 70 and 75. Then I'm not much bothered about the international scenario. Because India is not a big exporter. IT growth, 10 to 15% is going to come, right? Indian exports are today where they are in 2012-13. I don't see Indian exports dipping below this level regardless of what happens in the world. So I'm not so much concerned what's happened in the world. Mm. What concerns me in the world are two things. One is, I think sooner or later the euro is going to break. So we all got to have a very, we need to tune on what's happening in the euro. Mm. And I think that is one unknown which can really flag off things. And oil and commodity prices. I don't think anything else is going to really, the trade war and all, nothing going to happen in India.
You don't believe that there's going to be any collateral damage?
Yeah, I mean, India is not such big exporter and doesn't have those kind of, unless until Trump one day says no software imports. But that's not possible. Because the price differences and the costs are too apparent.
So the global factors don't particularly concern you today?
See, they will, I won't say, they may temporarily hit the market, but then they will come, the market will come back.